This curvy looking vehicle is the Renault Kadjar. It may have slipped past your radar, but there's a very good reason for that. So the Nissan Qashqai might be the number one seller in the UK, but you also have the Peugeot 3008, the Seat Ateca, the Kia Sportage, the Ford Cougar. Let's just say there's more rivals than I can count on my fingers, so you're quite spoiled for choice. Now this might be a Nissan Qashqai underneath, but you're not really going to notice why it's sat in here. Now a VW Tiguan might have better build quality, but the plastics used in here are much nicer than those in the Qashqai. Plus, this is far cheaper on list price than a Tiguan, and you get a lot of standard kit. There are 5 models to choose from, each coming with sat-nav, cruise control, DAB radio and Bluetooth. The 7-inch touchscreen isn't the largest in the sector or the quickest to respond to inputs, but the cabin has few buttons to clutter up the dash. Comfort-wise, these part leather seats on this signature model are firm and well bolstered and comfortable enough for longer journeys, despite the lack of any lumbar adjustment. And in the rear, there's plenty of headroom in here for most passengers, although with this sloping roofline, those passengers above 6 feet tall might find that an issue. You also sit quite close to the floor, so your knees are raised, so you might find legroom a bit restrictive. Now if we go around to the boot, you get a very reasonable 472 litres of boot space, which betters in Nissan Qashqai's 400 litres, but this still trails a Peugeot 3008 with its 591 litres. The boot itself is well-shaped and rectangular, and despite this false floor being a bit fiddly to use one-handed when you have shopping, this lever makes folding the seats a doddle. Let's face it, all the crossovers in this sector will never drive quite as well as their hatchback counterparts, but the Renault Kadjar is surprisingly capable on the road. Okay, the gear shift is a bit too light, but the steering and the pedals are very well weighted. There is a fair amount of body roll in the corners, but the Kadjar doesn't sway violently into them and never feels too flustered. It manages to grip well and manage a supple ride at the same time, even on these 19-inch wheels. There are 2 petrol engines to choose from and 2 diesels. We'd recommend a higher powered diesel with its balance of performance, reasonable refinement and running costs. You can also spec a 4-wheel drive system to go with this engine too, if you wish. The Renault Kadjar might not be the most memorable crossover in its sector, but it's definitely one that we can recommend. It manages to balance space, practicality and comfort without feeling like it's going to tip over on the road. It just about keeps it competitive with its rivals, but it's not one that stands up above the rest.